بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عباده الذين اصطفى. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless every single one of us and the Muslim ummah at large. As I said before the salah, alhamdulillah, the blessed month of Ramadan has roared into life. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst the maqbooleen, those who are accepted in this particular month. What a blessed month, a month of sacrifice. The month of the Quran. We listen to the verses of the Quran in Salatul Taraweeh, at least in Salatul Taraweeh. And I'm sure most of us would be completing the Quran, the recitation of it on our own, sometimes more than one time. And I'm sure most of us would like also to go into the meanings of the verses of the Quran. For many years, we have been going through verses of the Quran at this particular juncture when it comes to Salatul Taraweeh, going through some of the verses we have recited in the Taraweeh itself. This year, we are going to do it slightly differently. The reality is, if we take a look at the subjects and the topics that are discussed in the Quran, there are so many topics. Every juz, every surah speaks about different things. Sometimes the verses are repeated. Sometimes they are mentioned just once. And sometimes they are repeated so many times, whilst at other times the verses are actually repeated, but very little. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this choice of ours an acceptable choice. Alhamdulillah, what we will be doing is every day we will be taking topics and subjects, and we will be looking into verses from the entire Quran connected to that particular topic or those subjects, with the idea of looking at the various angles from which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has discussed those particular subjects. One of the most important subjects, what we are going to start with today, I'm sure a lot of you are probably scratching your heads to think, what is the subject? It is a subject that is of utmost importance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned it most in the Quran. Most of the verses of the Quran are directed at this particular subject. The subject is subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us take a look through the Quran. We will not be mentioning every single verse because we will be here until suhoor. And I'm sure most of us have things prepared for this particular suhoor, seeing that it is the first suhoor, mashallah. So we will look at as many verses as we can from the different angles, mentioning the surahs, inshallah, that these verses are mentioned in. The idea is to learn, to try and look at the method the Quran has used to get to us. Now, if we take a look at the opening verses of the Quran, we know that it is in a surah known as Suratul Fatiha, the opening surah. You know, in cricket, the opening batsman is a very, very important batsman. It is no example, and it does not fit when it comes to the Quran. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to call it with a similar name, Al-Fatiha. Fataha means to open. And Al-Fatiha is that surah that has now commenced the Quran. We repeated that surah so many times, and we do repeat it every single time we read our salah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those whose salah is acceptable. We enjoyed the tarweeha. None of us are complaining, alhamdulillah. And the idea is to sit and listen carefully to the words of the Quran, because these words will have an impact on us, even if we don't understand them. When you hear the makharij, the pronunciation of these words, and you listen to the eloquence of the Quran, subhanallah, it has a soothing effect on the mind. But only if you have the love of Allah within you. If you do not have the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within you, it will become a burden for you. Like the kuffar used to say, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْا فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ. They used to say, do not listen to this Quran and make noise whilst it is being recited, so that you can be from amongst those who win. So when the kuffar knew that if you would like to win, then you must abandon the Quran. You must make sure no one listens to it. We are the opposite. Allah says,
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها.
Will they not take the time and make the effort to try and understand the verses of the Quran? Or are its locks on their heart? May Allah make us not from amongst those whose hearts are locked and sealed from understanding the Quran. So the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how does the Quran address the issue of oneness? The fact that Allah is one, He is alone. He does not like partners. He does not permit us to associate partners. In fact, the greatest crime I could commit and you could commit is to associate a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says,
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
He decided to open the Quran with the words of praise, subhanallah. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds. The term Rabbun includes the creator, nourisher, cherisher, sustainer, provider, protector, curer, the one in absolute control. Remember, the one in absolute control. Look at how the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being made mention of in the opening words of the Quran. Then Allah says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. He is the most merciful. He is the most beneficent. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens this surah and opens the Quran with mention of His mercy, that He is the one who is merciful. Anyone else, that name Ar-Rahman, in that particular way, we are not allowed to even have it for ourselves. It is either Abdul Rahman, the slave of Allah, the slave of the most forgiving, the slave of the most merciful, Abdullah wa Abdul Rahman. None of us can call ourselves Allah. Nor can we call our children Allah. He is one, He is alone, He is the only one with that particular name. And the other qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we add an alif and a lam in front of them, they are singularly for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahman, referring to the most forgiving, the most merciful. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
Maliki yawmiddin.
That is another way of mentioning the oneness of Allah. Who is the owner of the Day of Judgment? There is not more than one. Just one. He is the supreme owner of the Day of Judgment. The one and only. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then draws our attention to the fact that we need to be careful who we worship. That is in the opening surah of the Quran.
إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ.
You alone we worship. Look at how the oneness comes in. Allah is telling us what to say. And Allah says, and we do say it in salah so many times, you alone we worship. You alone we seek help from. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us guidance. When it comes to seeking help and assistance, we need to realize that something that someone has, which is physically in front of you, which you can actually see, and you are asking them to assist you through that which is tangible, that which you can see, that which you can feel, and you feel Allah has given them the ability to give that to you, you are allowed to ask them for it. For example, you are sitting on the table and you ask someone, please pass me the salt. It does not mean now I must make a dua to say, Ya Allah, put it in the heart of that man to give me the salt. Because we are taught, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. You alone we seek help from. I need the salt from the other part of the table, Ya Allah. No, we know that it is Allah who has given the ability to that particular individual to pass us the salt. Now, after that, it's in the hands of Allah whether He allows that person to pass you the salt or not. They could just freeze. They could become paralyzed. They could suffer a heart attack as they are picking it up. That's in the hands of Allah. May Allah grant us good health, inshallah. But when it comes to issues of the unseen, issues that we know solely Allah is in control of, completely, and He has not allowed anyone a chance in it. Happiness, sadness, when it comes to good fortune, when it comes to sustenance and so on, we ask Allah alone to grant us that barakah and we seek refuge from shaitan. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah makes mention in the opening verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, just a few verses down, Allah says,
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ.
The address is to mankind at large. O mankind, worship your Rabb. I told you Rabb includes the one who created you, nourishes you, provides for you, sustains you, protects you, the one in control of your life. Worship your Rabb. Allah says, the one who has created you and created all those before you. Now look at how Allah is drawing our attention to His oneness through creation. He says, who made you? Who created you? Now He is drawing our attention to the fact that He is alone, He is one. Not only did He make you and me, but all those who died before us as well. Those who were created before us. It is amazing how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws our attention to this. Then we have another verse in the same surah, Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about those who were Jews, those who were Christians, the Sabians, those who believed in Allah, and those who believed in the last day. They have nothing to fear about.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَى وَالصَّابِئِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ.
Allah says, those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who were Jews the time Judaism was acceptable, at the time of Musa alayhi salam, those who were Christians at the time of Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, and Allah says, those who were Sabians and those who believed in Allah and the last day, for them there is no need to fear or worry. Allah will grant them their reward. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us truly from amongst those who believe. In these verses, take a look at how Allah draws our attention to His oneness by making mention of the last day as well. A very interesting point is, wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of hypocrisy, He always, or a lot of the times, He includes the issue of belief in the last day. Because if someone does not believe truly in the last day, you will find they will become hypocritical. They might say, we believe in Allah, but if their belief in the last day is not solid, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is a chance they might become hypocritical, and this will be detrimental for them. May Allah protect us from that. This is why, if we would like to protect ourselves from hypocrisy, it is important that we believe in the last day properly. We believe in the last day correctly. What does this mean? This means that at all times we are conscious of the answerability to our own Creator, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us. If we are at all times conscious of the answerability to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what would go wrong? Nothing at all would go wrong. Because we wouldn't be speaking out of turn. We would not be talking or walking out of turn. We would not be engaged in anything out of turn. Because we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking a record of absolutely everything. And we will be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's look at another verse where Allah draws the attention of ours to the oneness of His. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا.
Allah is saying, remember the time we took the covenant from the children of Israel, Ya'qub alayhi salatu wa salam, that they should worship none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do good to their parents. This was a covenant that Allah took from Banu Israel, but it is applicable to us as well. We should be worshipping none other than Allah and be good to our parents. Look at what Allah is saying. When He says, do not worship anyone but Him, but Himself, He is referring to the fact that He is one and alone. And how He connects it with our parents. One might ask, what is the connection between Allah and our parents? Very simple. It is a very close link. What is the link? Allah created us. Is that not correct? Yes, it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, and He chose as a means for our creation, our parents. That's the link. So Allah decided whom our parents should be. We did not decide that. None of us seated here, none of us listening, can actually claim that we decided who our parents are or were. Subhanallah. This is why Allah imposes upon us to say, be careful and watchful about my oneness, and immediately after that, watch your link with your parents. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us oppressive parents. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those children who will obey their parents where they are mentioning or commanding or ordering that which is reasonable. Remember, where they are unreasonable outside the fold of the Sharia, then that is where we stop, because Allah comes before everyone else. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the one who has surrendered to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Bala man aslama wajhahu lillahi wa huwa muhsin.
Nay, the one who has surrendered himself for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and has done good deeds, Allah says, for them there is a great reward which Allah has kept with themselves. Now, surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also is drawing our attention to the fact that He is one, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we are not to surrender to anyone else besides Allah. When the command of Allah comes, then that is first and last. If anyone's command falls within the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they happen to be from amongst the circle whom Allah has required us to obey, then we will obey them. Moments ago we spoke about parents. Anyone over you, or in authority over you, if they have ordered you something within the framework of what Allah has ordered, we will adopt it because it does not contradict with what Allah says. لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. There is no obedience for a creation or for part of the creation when it comes to the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone is imposing that you drink. The father tells the child, look, if you are my child, I want you to drink this bottle of alcohol. The answer is, no, my father, Allah comes before you. But when the father says, pass me the water from the fridge, it becomes a command because that's your father. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention or draws our attention to His oneness by something amazing. Again, He speaks about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam.
وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا وارزق أهله من الثمرات من آمن منهم بالله واليوم الآخر.
Allah says that, remember the time Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام made a dua, and he said, oh my Rabb, make this town, make this city of Makkah, Makkah al-Mukarrama, make it a very safe place, and grant its inhabitants with all forms of sustenance. Those who believe in you, those who believe in Allah, grant them sustenance, subhanallah. And those who believe in the last day, grant them sustenance. What is the connection of the oneness of Allah and the belief in the last day and sustenance? We should all understand that sustenance is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He might have kept the effort within our hands. To a certain extent, we need to try. How much we get, and how much blessings we get, in what we get, that is in Allah's hands, no one else's hands. A man can work for 10 hours and earn 50 rands. And a man can work for 1 hour and earn 50,000 rands. That's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the effort, it's the intellect as well. But the blessings are from Allah, the acceptance is from Allah. That man who earned 50 rands might be more content than the one who earned 50,000 rands. That's also from Allah. That man who earned 50,000 might have blown it in the casinos, or might have spent it in a way that he has no record of it. It went so quick. Whereas the man who has only 50 rands might still have some change after the week has finished. That's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember one thing. If you'd like to know and to increase the barakah in your sustenance and how you would get it, it is by abstaining from haram. Don't ever employ prohibited methods to earn a living. And don't ever spend your money on something prohibited, because if that is the case, you will lose blessings in your wealth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Then another very important point. Allah says, mentioning Ya'qub alayhi salam,
أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتُ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي
Were you there? Were you present when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when death came to Ya'qub alayhi salatu wa salam, were you there at the time? Let us tell you what happened. He called all his sons.
إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن بَعْدِي.
He did not ask them a question. Listen, my son, how much do you want from my estate? He didn't say 10% is yours and that house is yours and this building is yours and that is mine and this should be for my wife and so on. No, that was not the discussion at the point of his death. At the point of his death, he asked one simple question. What are you going to worship after me? Talk to me. Tell me. What have I taught you? So they responded,
قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا.
They said, oh our father, we will worship your Allah, the one you taught us to worship, and the one who was worshipped by our forefathers, Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq, may Allah's peace be upon them. One Allah. We are not going to associate partners with Allah. Imagine on his deathbed, what do we learn from this? The issue of the oneness of Allah, we need to teach our children up to the last breath. We need to continue repeating it, check it within ourselves and convey the message even to our children more than anyone else. Sometimes, mashallah, we know things, but we do not share it with our children. Look at this man, Prophet of Allah. He called his children, he gathered them, and he asked them a simple question. What are you going to worship after me? How many of us can be that concerned about the oneness of Allah and how important it is to teach our children regarding the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then, another very important point is we should all make dua to Allah to keep us upon that oneness. And our children as well.
رَبَّنَا وَجَعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ.
Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam, when he built the Kaaba with Ismail alayhi salam, he made a dua saying, oh Allah, make the two of us submitters unto you alone, and even from our offspring and our progeny, make from amongst us those who will submit to you alone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who can make a dua for ourselves, for our children, for our offspring, those to come up to the day of Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep them steadfast on this deen. Let's look at another point. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون.
When they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when my worshippers ask you about me, meaning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tell them I am very, very close. I am very near. I answer the call of every single caller immediately and positively. And Allah says, so let them call out unto me alone and let them believe in me alone in order for them to be rightly guided. So if we would like to be rightly guided, it's the oneness of Allah. Do you know what the hadith says? The hadith, which is a hadith Qudsi, meaning Allah is speaking. He says, أَنَا أَغْنَى الشُّرَكَاءِ عَنِ الشِّرْكِ مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَشْرَكَ فِيهِ مَعْيَ غَيْرِي تَرَكْتُهُ وَشِرْكَهُ. I am independent of the one who associates partners with me, and the one who was associated as a partner with me, I am independent of them, I don't need them. Whoever, Allah continues to say in this hadith Qudsi, he says, whoever associates a partner with me, I will leave him and that which he has associated, and I will throw them out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not throw us out. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws our attention to the fact that all the others have also believed in Allah alone.
آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله.
Allah says, the messenger has accepted that which was revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so have the believers, and all of them have believed and surrendered to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including the angels. So now Allah is drawing our attention, asking us a question that is hidden. It's not actually there, but we can understand it. If Allah is saying, they have all believed in me, are you going to believe in me as well? Or are you going to miss the boat? May Allah make us from amongst those who can also believe. We want to be included in this verse. We want to be included in the term mu'mineen, inshallah. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us, inshallah. Then the opening verses of Surah Al Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and I'm sure we've heard this verse many times,
Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum.
This verse appears in the Quran twice. Definitely it is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is living, the one who is ever living, subhanallah, the one who sustains and protects absolutely everyone. He is one, alone. He does not have any partners with Him, subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us to convey this message of oneness to others, including the Jews and the Christians. Allah says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go out and speak to the people of the book, those who have heavenly scriptures.
قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ.
O people of the book, go out and tell the people of the book, O people of the book, come to a statement that is common between us. What is the statement?
أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِّن دُونِ اللَّهِ.
The statement is that we should not worship gods besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us only worship the One. We must not associate partners with Him. And we must not take one another as gods besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is a statement. Allah is mentioning it. One is it has a lesson for me and you. And two is that it is actually referring to the message now being delivered to others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who can deliver the message to others, inshallah. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about hypocrisy in spending. This is the month of Ramadan. Many people are going to spend. May Allah accept that spending. Allah says, warning the people who are spending with a quality of hypocrisy. Allah says,
وَالَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا بِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ.
Allah says, and for those, and He's warning them, those who do not believe, or those in fact who spend their wealth in order to show off that I have spent so much, and this is from me, and that I am the one who's responsible of this and of that, and I did this and I did that. Allah says, if they are those from amongst them who do not believe in Allah and the last day. Remember, I told you when Allah speaks about belief in Himself and the last day, it is normally connected to hypocrisy. Either before that or after that, Allah is speaking of hypocrisy. So Allah is warning us to say, when you spend, only for Allah, only for His sake, no one else. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to watch it, and we want Him to be pleased with us, and we want Him to grant us all the goodness, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, regarding again those who say that Allah is one of three, part of a trinity, Allah says,
لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ.
And in another verse Allah says,
لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةً.
Those who have said that Allah is the third of three have actually disbelieved, and they've exited from the fold of submission. Allah says,
وَمَا مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ إِلَّا إِلَٰهٌ وَاحِدٌ.
No, the God is only one. The Creator, the worshipped one, is only one, singular. He is not a part of a trinity. Allah says, the issue of trinity does not make sense to those who have intellect. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all a deeper understanding. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, after he makes mention of himself, he says,
ذَٰلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ.
Take a look at that. Who is your Rabb? Look at the creation of Allah. Allah says,
خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ فَاعْبُدُوهُ.
He is the one who has created absolutely everything, so render your acts of worship to him alone, Allah says. Subhanallah. May Allah make us from those who are conscious of this. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, regarding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, commanding him, instructing him, قُلْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, say that my prayer, my acts of worship, my sacrifice, my life and my death is all for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No partners do I associate with him, because he has absolutely no partners. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those whose life and death is for the one who gave the life and the one who is going to take it away. Ameen. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention in Surah Al-A'raf and in many other surahs of the Quran of the previous prophets. And this is a lesson for us. Allah says,
وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَ أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا وَإِلَىٰ ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا.
Allah speaks about how he sent to the people of Hud or the people of Ad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them Hud alayhi salatu wa salam. The people of Thamud, Allah sent them Salih alayhi salatu wa salam. The people of Shu'ayb, Allah sent them, or the people of Madian, Allah sent Shu'ayb alayhi salatu wa salam. What did all these messengers say? Every single one of them, it is mentioned in the Quran.
قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُم مِّنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ.
Every one of them said to their people, worship Allah alone. You have no other deity besides Allah. There is no hope for me or for you besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who can take heed. Look at how Allah is drawing the attention of his oneness through mentioning what the previous prophets told them, their people. Surely we have a lesson to learn from that. If that was the core of the message, if that was the beginning of the message, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who can learn a lesson and who can follow inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the fact that when it comes to sacrifice for the sake of Allah, true believers who believe in Allah alone, they will not excuse themselves. They won't present some lame excuse.
لَا يَسْتَأْذِنُكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ أَن يُجَاهِدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ.
When it comes to sacrifice, when it comes to struggle with ourselves and with our wealth, when it comes to that type of struggle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who truly believe in Allah, they will not present excuses. And this draws our attention to the fact that when we believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then naturally we will be from amongst those who love to sacrifice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we come for salah, we have sacrificed. It's an effort. When we spend in the path of Allah, we will be spending out of the love of Allah. We won't become stingy and we won't only calculate in such a way that if there is a doubt, we use the lesser of the two figures. If that's the case, then there is something wrong with our belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in Surah At-Tawbah now about those who want to turn away. Those who want to turn away, Allah says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they turn away, all you should say is, look, Allah is sufficient for me and I believe in Allah alone.
فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ.
Now if they want to turn away, you should be upright and you should utter the words, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ, Allah is sufficient for me. and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alone. I entrust absolutely everything in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alayhi tawakkalt, He is the Rabb. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us every form of protection and every form, inshallah, of understanding. Then in Surah Yunus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. They needed the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They needed assistance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says,
وَقَالَ مُوسَى يَا قَوْمِ إِن كُنتُمْ آمَنْتُمْ بِاللَّهِ فَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلُوا إِن كُنتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ.
Musa alayhi salatu wasalam told his people that, O my people, if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then lay your full trust in Allah. So if we believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to lay our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is when the assistance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us every single form of assistance. And in this way, there are many, many verses in the Quran which draw our attention to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, Allah describes the day of Qiyamah. And Allah says in Surah Ibrahim,
يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ.
On that day, the earth shall be changed into a different earth.
وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ.
Allah says, on that day, even the skies shall be changed. And everyone will appear to Allah, the one, the most powerful, the irresistible, Al-Qahhar. Nobody can run away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us every form of benefit. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us in every single way. Look at how Allah is drawing our attention, describing the day of Qiyamah and saying on that day, He is one, He is alone, supreme Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah also subhanahu wa ta'ala, He brings the issue of His praise together with the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He says in Surah Al-Isra, right at the end, Allah says,
وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ.
Say, all praise is due to Allah who did not take anyone as a son or as a child. And He has not associated or He has not got anyone as a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anbiya, and this is a very interesting point, He is now describing to us in a different way that if there was more than one Allah, then there would be chaos. That is why there is one and there can only be one. Why would there be chaos? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
لو كان فيهما آلهة إِلَّا اللَّهُ لَفَسَدَتَا.
And in another verse in Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah says,
مَتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ مِنْ وَلَدٍ وَمَا كَانَ مَعَهُ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ إِذَا لَذَهَبَ كُلُّ إِلَٰهٍ بِمَا خَلَقُ وَلَعَلَى بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ.
Allah says, Allah has not taken a son. And there is no one as a partner with Allah. He does not have a partnership like we have partnership in business and so on. This one has 50%, that one has 50. No, there is no partnership, because if there was a partnership, the Quran says, every one of them would want to become haughtier than the other, higher than the other. You know, when you have two partners in business, 50-50, one says, it's me who's running the business. The other one says, no, it's me. One says, no, I'm the one who secures all the deals. The other one says, no, it's me who actually sends the customers there. The one says, I do the hard work. And the other one says, no, it's me who does the hard work. Subhanallah. One of them will tell you, I'm the one who made the microphone work. And the other one will tell you, no, it's me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So this is why it's important that we realize it's impossible for there to be more than one creator. The country cannot have more than one president. Why? Because they would not know what their portfolios are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. There would be confusion and there would be chaos on earth. So that is also a means of drawing our attention to the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. Then Allah draws our attention in Surah An-Naml of so many different items he has created. And after every verse, he says,
أَإِلَاهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ.
Is there a creator or is there a Rabb? Is there a God with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Look at all the creatures. Is there someone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Nay, there isn't. Allah says, but many of them don't understand. Many of them don't realize. And Allah says, no. After he asks the question a third and a fourth time, he says, glory be unto Allah. He is above all that they are describing and ascribing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect every single one of us. Then Allah draws our attention to his oneness through mentioning forgiveness.
غَافِرِ الذَّنْبِ وَقَابِلِ التَّوْبِ شَدِيدِ الْعِقَابِ ذِي الطَّوْلِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ إِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرِ.
Amazing how Allah says, he is the one who accepts repentance. He is the one who will forgive those who have erred. Amazing, subhanallah. And he is the one who holds severe punishment. He can choose to punish. May he not choose to punish us. May he have mercy on us and forgive us, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he is the one, everyone is going to return to him. Look at how Allah is drawing our attention to death. And the fact that death itself is a reminder that Allah is one. In what way? The one who made us is the one whom we are going to return to. The giver of life is the taker of it. And he is one, we are going to return to him. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding, inshallah. Then Allah makes mention of the fact that people will come to you and they will try and convince you that there is more than one Allah. They will try and convince you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not singular. He is not one and alone. And they will try and convince you to worship other creatures besides Allah. When we say creatures, we are talking of people. We are talking of wealth. We are talking of other laws, other deities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ, tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَأْمُرُونِي أَعْبُدُ أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ.
O you who are ignorant, are you trying to command me and to, are you trying to instruct me and order me to obey others besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I'm not a fool. What does this verse teach us? It teaches us that if people could try and go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to convince him to turn away from Allah, then surely people will come to us to try and convince us and to turn us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. We should not allow that to happen to us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then speaks about forgiveness. And he says,
فَعْلَمْ, you should know, أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ,
that there is none worthy of worship besides Allah.
وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ,
and seek forgiveness for your sin. Seek forgiveness for your sins. This verse was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was sinless. The lesson is for all of us, subhanallah. If Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked to seek forgiveness for sins he never committed, what about us? When we commit sins on a daily basis, there is only one whom we can turn to. The one whom Allah subhanahu, meaning the one who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then there are beautiful verses in Surah Al-Hashr, which I'm sure most of us know of by heart, where Allah makes mention of many of his names. I will not go into every single one of them, but let me recite the opening verses. Allah says,
هُوَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ.
He repeats that verse thrice there. And Allah says,
عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ.
He is the one who knows the unseen and he knows the seen better than anyone else. The unseen and the seen, which is also connected to the unseen. Subhanallah. When someone does a deed, we can see it, but we cannot see the sincerity behind it. Allah sees that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues and he says,
Al-Malik.
He is the one, the king, the owner, the supreme.
Al-Quddus. الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن.
Amazing, beautiful names of Allah. Allah alone, He is the supreme controller of absolutely everything. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about some people who will attack those who believe solely in Allah. And the fact that we who solely believe in one Allah, we need to realize that the others are not going to sit back and watch. There will be from amongst them those who will try to attack us just because we believe. Look at what Allah says. And it's all connected to the same topic. Allah says in Surah Al-Buruj,
وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا أَن يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ.
Why did they retaliate? Why did they attack the mu'mineen? There was no other reason for that to happen besides the fact that these mu'mineen believed in Allah alone. So when you believe in Allah alone, you should realize there will be people sitting and planning your downfall. Because that true belief has the power and the ability to grow so fast out of common sense today and always. Islam is the fastest growing religion on the globe. Intellectuals, especially females across the globe, are accepting Islam. Some statistics show that up to 50 or more than 50 people in the United States of America alone are accepting Islam on a daily basis up to today. Subhanallah. This is the oneness of Allah, because we do not take any risk when we worship. We worship the one who made us, the one who created us. The term Allah is derived from Ilah, the worshipped one. Aliha ya'lahu, meaning to worship. Al-ma'luhu, the one who is worshipped. That is the name Allah, the one who is worshipped. So we are calling him Allah. He decided for us to call him the one who is worshipped, so that we can eradicate and remove any risks of calling some individual name. Imagine, people call Moses, may Allah protect us. People call Jesus, may Allah protect us. People call out to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What guarantee do we have that these creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will actually respond to our call? What makes us different from the others who call out to others besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What makes us different is that we will call out to Allah alone. Whoever created me, that's whom I'm going to ask mercy from. Whoever made me, whoever I'm going to return to, that is whom I will say, O you who is the worshipped one, the one whom I'm going to return to, have mercy on me when I return to you. Subhanallah, no risks involved. And for this reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of an entire surah, the surah known as the surah of sincerity, Suratul Ikhlas. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. I see some of you are smiling, knowing that now we're coming to the end of the talk. Subhanallah. You know, it's towards the end of the Quran. Allah says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Say, Allah is one. He is singular. The one we worship, if someone wants to know who he is singular. He is one. He is alone. اللَّهُ الصَّمَدٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is supreme. He is independent. He does not depend on anyone. He is one of his kind, and that's it. He is not in need of absolutely anyone. لَمْ يَلِدْ. He does not give birth. He has never given birth. He does not beget. وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. And he was not begotten. He was not given birth to. He is the supreme. He has no beginning and no ending. He was there before the beginning and he will be there after the ending. That is Allah. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. No one, no creature, nothing at all can be similar to Allah in any of his names or qualities. That is a verse. That is an entire surah wherein that verse comes in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who realize and understand that He is alone, He is singular, He is one. He is the one who needs to be worshipped, and He alone will be worshipped. This topic of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so great. I hope and I pray that we have benefited from the various verses of the Quran which have discussed this issue of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have only mentioned but a few, and we have only mentioned certain angles. There are so many other verses. The Quran is full of declarations of the oneness of Allah. The question is, am I ready to understand and take heed and to leave everything besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and turn to Him alone? Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah wa bihamdih. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.